is all about. Now, management is called upon as the oldest of arts, which is called upon as the youngest of sciences today. So we can say management is oldest of arts plus the youngest of sciences. Now that is what the Bhagavad Gita says. Next slide, please. Okay, now some of these extraordinary personalities whom I have been reading over a number of years, first being Albert Einstein, who spoke upon his theory of relativity, which is so very simply called upon as E is equal to mc squared. Now, probably speaking it from a very simple language as to what E is equal to mc squared is all about, all I can say is the theory of relativity is like when you touch a stove for a second, it burns for an hour. But if you sit next to your wife for an hour, it feels like a second. The Einstein's theory of relativity from the viewpoint of managerial thinking. Second is called upon as the gentleman which was the father of creation, who says that if at any point of time I went on to become depressed, I opened up any page of the Bhagavad Gita, randomly put on my finger on any of the verses, and there I found the solution to each and every problem that I had in my life. Now that is the most significant thing about the Bhagavad Gita, something that I don't request, but probably I would force all my students to read upon, that if at any point of time in your life you come upon any problem, please randomly open up the Bhagavad Gita, randomly put your finger on any of the page and most importantly on any of the verses, and rest assured of the fact I am that you will find a solution to your problem itself. Right. The most important thing that management actually speaks about is what is a mind. Because we need to have a world-class mind to make a world-class organization. A mind that can think beyond its time, a mind that can see what is happening in the future itself. So what is it that Arjuna said to Lord Krishna? That mind is very restless, forceful and strong, O Krishna. It is more difficult to control the mind. It is more difficult to control the mind than to control the wind. What is it that Sri Krishna said as to the answer as to what is a mind from a managerial perspective? You see, a mind strikes harmony in working equilibrium in thoughts and actions, goals and achievements, plans and performance, products and markets. A mind resolves situations of scarcities, be there in the physical, technical or human fields, through maximum utilization with the minimum available processes to achieve the goal. Now, that is what the definition of a mind is from the Bhagavad Gita perspective and the definition of a mind from a managerial perspective. Right? Please. Right. If you look into what an organization is, the definition of an organization itself comes from the Bhagavad Gita itself. I mean, the Bhagavad Gita actually gave birth to the word organization, if you ask me. Why? Because as per, you might have heard about the gentleman called one as Harry Coons, who wrote down the book called Organizational Behavior. He says that an organization is a rational coordination of a number of people working towards a common explicit purpose called upon as goal congruence through the division of labor and function and by the hierarchy of authority and responsibility. The Bhagavad Gita says no less. Because when Arjuna's son called upon as Abhimanyu for the Chakravyuha, the Bhagavad Gita speaks about concepts like ambition, it speaks about concepts like opportunity, it speaks about command, and most importantly, it speaks about teamwork. If you look into the word opportunity itself, now there came a story where a young couple were once sleeping in the room and someone knocked on the door, knock, knock, knock. So the wife tells the husband that, sir, why don't you, I mean, not sir, husband, please open the door. Opportunity is there outside. So he says, go back to sleep. After 10 minutes, someone else knocks the door. Knock, knock, knock. So she says, go open the door. You know, opportunity is just outside. He says, just go off to sleep. Again, someone knocks the door. Knock, knock, knock. And she says, please now open the door. He says, just go off to sleep. Because opportunity never knocks thrice. It just knocks once. And as business managers are excellent when we perform in isolation. The moment we are a team, I don't need to say anything, right? That's a fact. You know, you look into the Indian cricket team, you know, everyone is excellent. We have best batsmen in the world, we have some of the finest bowlers, we have the wall, each and everything. But you put them together, then none of them actually perform. So that is what we need to take into consideration, that in life, there is no such thing as self-made man. You will only come up with the help and the blessings of others. Right, next slide please. Okay, so let us understand the beginning of the end. Now the Bhagavad Gita is a part of Vyasa Muni's called upon as the Mahabharata, where Arjuna had to fight a brother, Karna also were there. So at that point of time, Lord Krishna tells him that when Arjuna saw many of his friends and relatives in the opposing army, he became overwhelmed with compassion, lost his determination and the courage. So what did Lord Shri Krishna have to say? Right. He says that the world is full of possibilities, my friend. Just as the only way to discover the limits of the impossible is to go beyond them into the impossible, because the word impossible says, I am possible. Right. So the second thing is all about challenge. Now this is something that even sets apart from most of us to the corporate world itself, that there are going to be challenges each and every day, each and every moment you live in your life is full of challenges per se. So challenge is called upon as the always set the trail, never ever follow the path. Right. Let's take about the word success. When you say the word success, it comprises of S-U-C-C-E-S-S, strength, understanding, character, compassion, empathy, strive, and your own style that will make you a successful person as a human being that you are itself. Likewise, what even the Bhagavad Gita says, that to strive to make a difference in your own creative way is truly to be successful in the life you live each day. So life's battles are not always won, but the stronger the faster man. But sooner or later, the man who wins is the man who thinks he can. So if you think you will lose, you are lost. For out in this world, we find that success begins with a fellow's will. It's all in the state of mind. Thank you. We even spoke about the opportunity itself, that opportunities will never knock you thrice. It will just knock you once. And opportunities come only once in a lifetime. And whenever they come, they always come in the disguise of misfortune and unfortunately always to the back door. So you need to know when the opportunity strikes, get hold of it, grab it, and make sure that you win. Right, next slide please. Okay, corporate battlefields are always called upon as your move. So what is your move as to what Bhagavad Gita says? That if life is a game, then play it. If life is a challenge, meet it. If life is an opportunity, most importantly, capture it. Because what happens to a man is less significant than what happens within him. Right. Okay. Now, at that point of time, Arjuna was not very, very determined to fight against his own elders, his own brothers. So, Shri Krishna tells him that please be very determined in life, because determination is nothing but tenacity. And tenacity is nothing but your own guts to feel about. Just as the way when I am making a presentation, unfortunately as a person, I don't believe in PowerPoint slides, I don't believe in OHPs. But this being a very formal occasion, I have to make these things, because I am the kind of person who speaks right from my body into your mind, right from my mind into your soul, right from my soul into your spirit, right from my spirit into your instincts, right from my instincts into your intuitions, right from my intuitions into your mindsets. And that is what it means. World over has given us a plethora of definition as to what leadership is all about, whether it is Philip Kotler, whether it is Peter Drucker, whether it is John C. Maxwell, whether it could be the who's who of the corporate world itself. But if you ask me, leadership is such a very simple kind of a concept. Exactly after the 11th September attacks, Colin Powell made a very simple statement that leadership is all about showing reality and giving hope. And that is what even Sri Krishna said, that leadership is just showing you reality, that you have to fight even if it is your own brothers. Because if you have to fight, you have to fight and you have to fight and you just cannot give up. So leadership is all about showing reality and at the same time giving hope that you will and you can and you shall and you will definitely win. Thank you. Next slide. Okay, so what happened then? At that point of time, chapter number 7, verse number 6 came into being, that yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata abhyutthana dharmasya tadatmanam srajamyaham. The Supreme Lord, unlimited mouth, unlimited eyes, unlimited wonderful visions. That's why it's again said that if there's anything that could go wrong in this world, or if at any point of time I feel that our country is going to be beheaded in some way or the other, I believe I shall, in some shape or the other, always and always cease to exist. That is what the words actually means. And that is what gave inspiration to Arjuna to fight against the battle with his own brothers. Right. Right. So when it comes to yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata abhyutthana dharmasya tadatmanam srajamyaham, what does management have to say about this? Management says that the greater the adversity, the brighter is the light of opportunity. And if you want to doubt something in your life, don't doubt yourself. Mostly, I mean, do not doubt yourself, but doubt your limits. Because in life, sky is the limit. Every cloud has a silver lining. Most importantly, it is never too late to mend. And most importantly, have the courage and the will to win. That is what the Bhagavad Gita in the managerial context, or probably management in the Bhagavad Gita context, says as to what adversities are all about. Right. If you ask me one such thing, you know, I've come across so many people in my corporate life, even in my entrepreneurial age, that, you know, I am a self-made man. You know, many people tend to say this. I feel that there is no such thing as a self-made man. I mean, it's not possible that you can become a self-made man. Yeah, you can become an independent thinker. You know, you can be independent in your own work. You can be independent in your own mind. But how can you become a self-made man? Because even when you were born, you cried and there was someone else who took care of you. So there is no such thing as a self-made man. And most importantly, you will reach your goals only with the help of others. And most importantly, if you want to ask something, ask for wishes, because wishes are nothing but blessings in disguise. That is something that even I intend to ask from my students, because materialistically, there is nothing that you can give me. Monetarily, there is nothing that I could ask for. So what I am asking from all of you is nothing but your wishes, because your wishes will give me blessings in disguise to go ahead and be the man that I am supposed to be and achieve those things which I am supposed to achieve in my life. Right. Okay, so what is the main context of the Gita itself? Now, the Gita was taught to transform Arjuna, who had become Arjuna, which is called upon as a weak person, to a Dhirya, which is called as a heroic warrior, on the basis of two things. One is challenge, and second is called as quit. So Lord Shri Krishna again says that strike your best when you are the hardest hit, because that's the time you must just not quit, because winners don't quit and quitters don't win. Okay. A very important aspect that even I learned over a period of my corporate life is that change is probably the most constant thing. That is what even Karl Marx would say, that change, my friend, is the most important thing. So what does the Bhagavad Gita again say is that God grant me serenity to accept things which I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know thy difference. You see, every day in your corporate life, or every day even that you are in a student, we have come across that no two moments are the same. So forget the fact that even no two days are going to be the same. Every moment you live has to be a moment in which you have to make sure that your path is towards self-realization. Every moment that you breathe is towards the path called upon as moksha, and that is when you will have mukti. So when you go back in time, you speak about shantiha, you speak about ananda, and most importantly, you speak about atma jnana. So every moment that you have to live from now onwards, make sure it is a dream to get into realization, is to get into atma jnana. Right. Next slide, please. So the central message of the Gita is that everyone in life, regardless of his performance, go into something which is called as Swadharma. It is indicated in the first word of the first verse and the opening chapter. Most importantly, even the last word of the last word speaks about two words, which is called as Mama, it's called as mine, and most importantly, it's called as Dharma, which is called as duty. So this is probably the central crux that even management speaks about, and what management is all about. Right. Right. The Bhagavad Gita says that every human being in this world, when he takes birth, has five types of rent that he has to pay. The first is called as bhakti rent, a dedication and a devotion towards your God, which is very, very essential. You know, most of us today that I have seen are not very religious. Please make sure that you believe in God up there. Always remember that there is someone up there who is looking and watching each and every moment that you live. And most importantly, after having a lot of faith in Him, have tremendous faith in yourself, because it's all about faith. Right. Second is called as Bhumirena. This is called as a dedication and a devotion towards your own country. Imagine the fact that what would we be if we were not Indians per se. Agree to the fact that we might have the best of the brains and the best of the culture, but most importantly, we have the worst of the patients. Which is the fact. So we need to have some duty towards our country also. And third is called as Samajikrena, a debt or a devotion towards your own society. When I came across some of the greatest of business leaders that I have met in my life, whether it could be Mr. Gautam Adani, whether it could be Shri Karsanbhai Patel, whether it could be so many that I have interacted with on a daily basis, they said, Rajiv, the greatest of business leaders always had two things in common. One, they started very early in their life, and two, they always did something out of social responsibility. So I thought that if I aspire to be like them, which I know that I shall be anyways, yes, I have started very early in my life, but two, there is nothing that I did out of social responsibility. So I thought, let's walk into a few B schools and let's just go and help as many of our students as possible. Because eventually, you are not 61 students in front of me, you are 61 careers at the end of the day. And that is probably the most important thing that I have to say. I only counted them. Okay. The fourth is called as Pitru Rena, a debt towards your own elders. Probably the most important thing, you know. How many of us actually go and touch the feet of our parents every day? Honestly speaking, you know, we believe in the Hindu culture, we believe in the Muslim culture, we believe in the Christian culture, but we forget the fact that the God itself lies in our home, in the form of our own parents, you know. When we take the case of Lord Shiva and Parvati, Ganpati just had to move around his parents to say that I have conquered the world, when Kartika actually went all around the globe 7 times to me. So always remember the fact that after something which is called as a bhakti rin, a bhumi rin, a samajik rin, then comes a pitru rin, a rin or a debt towards your own family. Then comes a swayam rin, a debt towards yourself. I mean, am I being the human being that I am supposed to be? Am I doing what I am supposed to do? Am I going towards the goal which I have destined for myself to be? When you do all these things, you actually do your karma. and karma, according to Bhagavad Gita, important thing that entrepreneurs and even corporates today don't intend to give. And that is what even the Bhagavad Gita says, that whatever you want to do, make sure that there is some value attached to it. Because good values will build good value systems. Good value systems will make great organizations. Great organizations will have probably the greatest of cultures. And that is what challenge is all about. Second is called as faith. Likewise, I said that life is not about achievements, you know. One more thing that I realized, that after a certain strata that I achieved for myself, I realized that life is not about achievements. It's all about winning in your own eyes. It's all about breaking your own records, and most importantly, going beyond your own capacity. Now that is what is called as faith. Set targets, but do not compare them to others. Set targets against yourself, because you are your own best friend and you are your own worst enemy. So most importantly, have a target against yourself. That is probably the most important thing that even Nikshama Karma says, that actions without the consideration of rewards. Likewise, when it comes to leadership, you know, we have heard Philip Kotler and Peter Drucker and Zig Ziglar and Anthony Hopkins, and I mean, I don't know how many of them are actually there. Across my B-school life, I read around 26 definitions of management, and I could not even understand any of them. Management is all about managing eventually. Most importantly, we can say that management is like taking into consideration the facts that the best of managers are the ones who get things done effectively to other people. That is what management is all about. Think about it. The best of managers are able to effectively get things done to other people. Like, you know, if you take what even Lord Shri Krishna said, that management needs those who practice, most importantly, what they preach. That is very, very essential, right? So management is maintaining, creating and designing an environment in which individuals working together as groups is what management does. Undoubtedly, it's the oldest of arts called upon as Bhagavad Gita, plus the youngest of sciences called upon as contemporary management. That is what management is all about. And my friend, it's not about balance sheets, it's not about credit control, it's not about debt recovery. Take my word for it. That is not management itself. Okay. Next slide, please. Realize the mission, cultivate the art of leadership, establishing institutional excellence, building an institutional organization. He cannot expect the fact that someone else will work for him, because if he has to extract work out of others in a most genuine way, he has to make sure that his human resources are to be taken care of in probably the most important way. Not only the human resources, but even the best of the talent has to be taken into consideration. When Duryodhan wanted the help of Lord Shri Krishna, he did not want Lord Shri Krishna's help. He wanted the help of his gallant army which was there behind. But Arjuna wanted his guidance. Now that is the difference between an entrepreneur thinking in one way or an entrepreneur thinking in another way. Likewise, I said, an entrepreneur is a person who habitually creates and innovates to build something of recognized values around perceived opportunities. Now this is where you need to understand as to where the opportunity locks. Likewise, I say, this knocks once and not thrice. Okay. Thus, management is a process of aligning people, getting them committed to work for a common goal to the maximum social benefit, most importantly, in search of excellence. That's what even Tom Peters says, that life is always about in search of excellence. That is very, very essential for us to understand. Okay. When you speak about Gita and globalization in one way or the other, you see, when the Mahabharata was acted to Dhritarashtra without even being over there, that gave birth to the television. Which is for a fact. Now, even if we take into consideration television, we are able to see things which are happening in other countries. This was actually motivated by when Sanjaya was reciting the entire war to his king. And then the concept goes even further. Likewise, even Krishna says that the world is eventually going to become a very small place. So don't worry whether, you know, you will be able to reach there or not. And that's what even globalization and management says. That globalization is based on the concept that the world is a single unit for key decision making. It means the free transfer of goods, services and capital throughout the world. It further means the opening up of national economies to global markets with a simultaneous and a corresponding reduction in the role of the state to frame policies especially for the benefit of the poor. Now that is what even the Gita had preached already. So instead of reading Philip Kotler, I really request you to start reading the Bhagavad Gita. You will not need me. You will not need the mecca of all business schools, because one thing you need to understand, that even the Bhagavad Gita says there are two things in this world that no one can teach you. One is called as decision making, two is called as risk taking. Now these are the two things that no Harvard Business School is going to join your hands and say, okay Kunal, you sold me the NCD, sir, let's go and sell a few things to others. It's not going to work that way, because you need to have tremendous faith in God, and most importantly, a tremendous faith in yourself. Because life is all about Nikshama Karma, actions without the reward, consideration. Thanks. I mean, I'm happy that you are away. At the next slide, please. Okay. Bhagavad Gita even speaks about what organizational behavior says, effectiveness and efficiency. Now, efficiency is more about doing the things right, and effectiveness is doing the right things. Now, there is a huge contrast between the two. One is doing the right things, secondly, doing the things right. Now, that is what the Bhagavad Gita speaks when it comes to managerial effectiveness, that utilization of available resources. That is something that even management speaks about. Now, resources could be of four types: men, method, machine, and money, the most important resource. Second comes an attitude towards your work. Now, likewise, I always say that your attitude will be a determinant or a function to your altitude. If we have any engineers over here, that's why I use the word dy dx or function of your altitude. Because, you know, for an optimist, the glasses are full. The pessimist, the glasses are empty. But for an engineer, the glass is twice the size it's supposed to be. Then comes work commitment. If you speak about the work commitment, when you say it, you got to mean it. When you mean it, you got to do it. And only if you do it, shall you prosper in life. It is so very essential to have commitment. You know, commitment speaks about that your heart is in your objective. Commitment speaks about convictions. You know, many businessmen or many corporates that you will come across have very strong convictions. But the second attachment to it is standing to your convictions. Whether you are there to sell yourself, whether you are there to, most importantly, sell a product or a service, because many people don't even know the difference between marketing and sales. I've already said that to my students, that there is this guy who goes to a girl and proposes to her, she says no. He goes there and proposes to her, she says no. He goes again and proposes to her, she says no. He goes again and proposes to her, she says yes. That is called as sales. Right? There is this guy who goes to a girl, he speaks about himself, and the girl proposes to him. That's called his marketing. I must have interacted with more than 500, probably 600 corporates in my life, from GMs to VPs to CEOs, India, abroad.